everybody, welcome to Power Wash Simulator. Today we're going to be happier giving this game a try. I have been playing this game for quite a while now. I have done quite a bit when it comes to progressing and stuff like that. I have unlocked already the, you know, heavy power washer and stuff like that. This is a pretty interesting game. It does take a very long time. You can literally spend just about all day playing this game. Just one map, and it could take forever. So, this game does require a lot of time, you know, a lot of patience. Sometimes you just miss things. But I've been really enjoying it so far. So, let's go and hop in things here. Let's go and do things. Now, this may be a several episodes here, just, you know, how long this takes, you know, but I am going to do my best to try to, you know, make it as short as possible. But we're going to go with cleaning the, you know, treehouse here. So first thing I like to do is, well, we obviously have, I don't know what the hell this thing is. Not that we can interact with, I don't think. I don't think there's anything we can interact with. Asked me if I could pick up a broom, but I can't do anything with it, so. Alrighty, so we do have this, which definitely comes in quite a bit of handy here, especially reaching tall things here. I like to go around and just look at things here. Got another camera over here. I want to try to. Doesn't look like I can do anything. We can move the camera around, but well, it gave me an option to do something with that other one. I don't know what it was though. Oh. I don't know why it likes this much. I popped up a thing for a minute, but that's not doing anything. I don't know what this is. Oh. I guess this doesn't do anything. Very weird. Alrighty, so let's go do this here. Okay, this is really slow for me. I fix this every time and it does not stay. Oh, where the cursor, because it. No, that's that. Go ahead and do this. A little bit higher. It's okay. Alrighty, so something that I like to do is I'm gonna be realistic with this because I've done power washing in the past. It's a little bit just, you know, clean a house and stuff like that. And realistically, you want to start from the top, work your way down, at least from what I have experienced. Just because I'm looking for the damn ladder. Where is it? Usually they give you like a ladder that you can use. I'm not seeing it. Maybe it's like laying on the ground someplace. Okay, so this doesn't make any sense right now. I'm confused. There's no foot stool either, which is something that you usually have. You can't even go by the van. So I guess we're gonna have to work with what we have. Oh, here's a ladder. Footstool. Jeez, I walked right past it. Okay, so I like using the yellow nozzle. It's just the most powerful. It's a lot better. I'm gonna turn this game volume down. Sorry guys, I just first time getting in here and stuff like that. Okay, so things should be better now. Hopefully. So I'm gonna try to explain what I'm doing and stuff like that and how this game works. So the controls, you are told from the beginning, it's not difficult. Up is how I do the free movement thing, or up on the D-pad is free movement. Right is, you can see all the dirt. It's pretty much useless, especially if you're done and, you know, there's maybe one or two small things that you have to work on, and it's just annoying, so, pretty unreliable. I don't like... Only down on the D-pad does it do anything. I'm pressing and it does not do anything. I used to press right on the D-pad. Left is how, for the nozzle for water, you can press right trigger and you can do this. And you can hold right trigger or left trigger. You can hold it and it will like lock in place. So that is really hit. Handful, or it helps a lot. Left. I'm sorry. God, so was it right bumper? It was left trigger. They can use that, and right and left under. Bumpers, change nozzles. X, you can pull up your extension and stuff like that. A, you can jump. B, you can select your cleanings. And Y, you can select your nozzles with this menu here. So that's kind of the controls a little bit. What I like to do is I like to clean off as much junk as I can. I possibly can with just a regular nozzle, and then we'll move to the high power nozzle. This is not the default power washer. There's several. I mean, get light duty, medium duty, and heavy duty, and professional, I believe. This is the heavy duty. I'm not gonna get the first. The professional. This is a nozzle that you can purchase as well, which I really like. It's for all the power washers. Gives the little high power spinning effect. It really, really helps. You just go crazy with it pretty much. And you also have your shampoo, which I have right here. You don't want to be careful with this because you can go crazy on this thing. And the store will actually run out of stock. So, you got to be really careful with that. So, I try to not use too much unless it's just crazy. Where I find it necessary to use it. And I pretty much go one section at a time here. We'll work on that in a minute. Oh, we just fell off the fucking roof. God damn it. You don't pay attention, you can do. Definitely do that. There's a fucking ladder. But. Thankfully, in this game, of course, there is not a death script or anything like that. So if you fall off the roof, it's not a big deal. You're not gonna die, nothing happens. So you don't really have to worry about that. You gotta actually use that to your benefit if you want, because I have, like, one of those, those things right here where the, where I'm pointing out over there, I jump off of those things all the time, because it takes forever to climb down those damn ladders. Now, when it comes to this game, you have in the left top corner there, they have like sections of what you are cleaning. Sometimes they're bigger sections, sometimes they're very small. You know, but almost everything has its own assignment. So if, you know, you forgot to clean something or whatnot, or you really just faced it. Or you thought you may have cleaned something, but it wasn't complete. You can go through here, look at the top left corner, go through all this, and see what you have missed. Or, you can go into the menu and you can see what all has not been cleaned. Mind you, if there's a lot of objects that are the same, it can be confusing as hell, so sometimes you have to just go through everything again and see what you have missed. Now, once you clean something, which hopefully you guys will get to see, I don't know, this can take forever to do, but once you've cleaned something, the game will ding at you. It'll flash blue for a few seconds, and that's how you know you've cleaned something. Well, of course, you can go through all this here. Also, have to refill the cleaning liquid. Mind you, like I said, you gotta go easy on this because you can't depend on it too much. Now, if you wanted to start from the bottom, you could when it comes to this game, because it doesn't have drop stages like real life. But in real life, you want to start from the top because water, you know, gravity. So all that dirt is going to float down. And therefore, you would have to do everything all over again. So you want to start from, you know, the bottom in real life, but you don't have to in this game. Also, with this game, it is fairly decent when it comes to, you know, when it comes to graphics and actually, you know, being able to, you know, play the, you can easily play this game on a low-end PC. I have a decent computer. I have, I really should put this in the about page of the channel, but I haven't got around to it. I think it actually is. I'm not 100% sure. I haven't worked on that in a while. I need to, but I have a RTX 2060, the MSI version, and it is 12 gigabytes of VRAM, and I have 16 gigabytes of RAM, and I have a AMD Ryzen 7 5600. Which, honestly, you know, I'm not surprised, or I am quite surprised I don't get better performance than I do. I've tried everything to try to get, you know, better performance out of a lot of games, but I just haven't been able to figure it out, unfortunately. Everybody just being loud today. I don't even know what's going on. Usually people are pretty respectful and quiet. It's the early in the day, so. Well, it's like 4 o'clock when I'm recording this right now, so. See, well, we did this, and it's possibly I missed it, but that is what it looks like when something is complete. Now, both of these are complete now. You don't have to worry about it anymore. Sometimes it's specific on how much you clean. Sometimes it is not. Certain things, you can still have a lot of dirt left over and it'll clear anyways. The game will give you that. There's no setting that you can, you know, change for that. Unfortunately, I wish there was. For guys that wanted to do this a little bit easier, but there is a simulation, so but as I was saying, you know, some, you know, items, you know, like I said, you know, you can, you know, still have a little bit of dirt left over and stuff like that that you need to clean, and it will clear anyways. It just depends on what you're doing and what it actually said out in the game. Now, something I do have to warn you about, this game is not perfect at everything. And you gotta be really careful, when it comes to playing the game too long, because personally for me, this is not everybody, but I have gotten headaches from playing this game for too long, you know, which is unusual. I have played some pretty bad games. I don't know, I guess it's just the way this view works. It can get dizzy sometimes, and you gotta be careful, but that's kind of one of the downsides of this game. Also, another thing that I think this game might be missing out on a little bit is when it comes to, like, sidewalk power washers. Like, it's kind of hard to explain. I don't know exactly what they're called, but it's where that, you know, it's like floor power washer. You can, you know, push it on the floor and it's like super powerful. You know, it's better than having to take this handheld power washer and do spray all the floors with it. You guys probably know what I'm talking about. The professionals that do this in real life. Firstly, like, this game doesn't have it, so really sucks, but maybe this game will be, maybe this will be implemented. I believe this is still early access. I believe there's still work on this game. Actually, I haven't really seen an update from this game in a while. I'm hoping they do. You know, this is a pretty good product as it is. It'd just be nice to add more things to it. Also, another thing that's interesting, you can customize these power washers. You know, you can have, like, different colors and stuff like that. Of course, that costs in-game money. So, I'll show you guys what the shop looks like and stuff like that here. Towards the end of the video here. Also something interesting to talk about while we were sort of talking about computers here. So, I have been having an issue where, well, I think I fixed it, but for a reason, my computer just kept on randomly restarting at some point. I don't know what was causing that. Everything is almost brand spanking new on my computer, so it's hard telling what it could be. They seem to be doing a lot better, for now anyways. So hopefully that problem is fixed. And everything seems to be working a lot better, at least in my opinion anyways, when it comes to everything. You know, just after, you know, messing around with, you know, stuff and everything like that. See what I mean? No, it just did it right there where, even though there was dirt still left over, it cleared it anyway, so very nice to have that. But we have taken care of the roof. Wow, it just got just so weirdly quiet. Alrighty, so now we can start working on the bottom here. Also, from with this game, when it comes to the footstool, like we had, when it comes to stuff like this, that thing almost becomes useless. Like, you can't even do anything with it. I really, really use it, so I don't know why that's even in the game, but maybe it's something you can use firsthand, but left trigger, you can rotate the nozzle. That's something I forgot about. All the controls are listed as soon as you start the game, every time. I don't think you have the ability to even turn that off. When it comes to these window ledges, you gotta make sure you get the size that we want to place. The window ledges and windows are two completely different things, always. So you need to make sure you get both, or something you will forget about. I've done it. Also, polls are a separate thing, too. Most of the time. I forgot about this. See, this is kind of like the small stuff that you can forget about. Some of that will definitely hold you up in completing this section here, so we'll make sure you do it. Down on the right D-pad, you can crouch as well. I'm going to give you guys as much information when it comes to controls as much as possible. Although they're pretty simple. Also, like, some things are just, you know, all around put together, like this lower trim here. It's all the way around the house, so you won't be able to do that until you get done with all of it, pretty much. So just something to keep in mind, sometimes it just really depends on how things are added together. Sometimes it matters, sometimes, you know, it doesn't. Got these lanterns. See, this is like the small thing that you can miss. Just gotta be really careful. Or you can, like, you can spend, you know, days, hours, just trying to find what you have missed. Like, make sure I got that. I don't remember if I did or not. And some of that, you know, I've learned to start feeling here is once you get done with like a large section or something like that, you know, I try to, you know, just go through it, make sure I've gotten everything, you know, just so you don't have to go searching for it all the time. When it comes to the game, I think it just really depends on, you know, only a certain amount of people are gonna like this game. You know, it just takes that certain person. You know, I find it to be very relaxing. Sometimes it can be annoying, but most of the time it is pretty relaxing. I would say the most annoying thing about this game is just not having, you know, cleaning supplies. You know, not having cleaning liquids or something like that. That gets pretty annoying, especially if you really need it. The most that I probably ever use those for is cars. You know, cars are very annoying. Deal with a lot of rust, and that cleaning supply can really help, you know, remove all that stuff. So, well, what I was saying is, you know, typically when I put cars in, of course, they have a lot of rust, and it's annoying to have to use the high power washer, or the high pressure nozzle all the time. Very time consuming, and it just sucks. And you only have a certain number that you can use it, or limited. I'll show you guys, but yeah, we still have a lot to go. This is just the beginning with this. individual things here, but what are you gonna do? Oh yeah, I'll go get that ladder. Window frames are the worst. They're just so bad. Alright, good. I'll probably get the ladder. Sometimes you just... Actually, it may have to because I can't get that door. Okay, so let me get this ladder real quick. Man, that's so quiet. I can turn out the power washer. Oh yeah, I think that's just the same for... I think it's all connected. Okay. We got the upper wall trim. I wasn't sure. So hard to get underneath here. Thank you. Okay. We're gonna go double check everything there, but. I have to remember to check all these poles. I'm not talking to you guys very much, I'm just focusing on what I'm doing. Which is I'm getting everything here. Probably gonna get the ladder for this one too because this is pretty high. Oh, this is actually going very well. This is pretty good. Jesus. Okay, guys, so this took quite a bit to, even just complete this little small building over here. We still have, of course, a lot to do. If you guys want to see more of this, let me know. But I think I'm going to be wrapping things up here, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.